Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. Today we're going to be talking about Abbyy Fine Reader PDF 15, but specifically looking at the PDF functions and not the OCR functions. So today we're going to focus on using Abbyy Fine Reader PDF 15 to edit and view a PDF document. The first thing I want to do is launch Abbyy Fine Reader, and then I'm going to select Open PDF Document. And then I'm going to open a rather large PDF so that we can start to edit it. Now, this particular document is actually 630 pages long, and most PDF documents are not going to be that large. However, let's go ahead and jump somewhere into the content. Let's take a look at how to use the crop tool within Abbyy Fine Reader. I want to get rid of some of these publisher marks on the top and sides of the document. For more up-to-date Abbyy Fine Reader videos and best practices in accessibility, hit that subscribe button. Now back to the video. I'm going to select the crop tool from the top menu, and Abbyy makes a selection for me of what content it thinks I'm trying to cut. It appears that there is a small window in the bottom right corner, and I want to actually crop all pages. Now in this selection tool, I can select custom, or just the odd pages, or just the even pages. Now, this may mess up some of my pages. However, I still want to run this crop tool, and I'm going to select all pages. If I wanted to adjust the crop, I could simply drag and drop the boxes from around the text. Then I'm going to select apply crop. Now, this may take a few minutes because this is a 630-page document. Okay, it looks like the crop is finally finished. Let's go back to say page 22 and review the crop. And it looks like it cut off just a little bit of the extra text, which is great. So I can deselect the crop tool now. All right, so to get back to the other tools, I need to select the PDF tools button from the top right corner. My camera was covering it, and so I'm going to move my video back up there. But this is where you can switch from form editor to PDF tools and so on. So if you wanted to make some changes to your PDF, there are some things you can do. For example, we can select the edit button, and this will allow us to not only add text if we wanted to, but it will also let us change the text on the page. Now, in this particular file, it appears that some of my words are shifting in the column, so you want to be careful when working with complex PDFs. However, it's really nice if you need to make some spelling updates or just minor changes to a document. Next, we can use tools like highlighting to choose a specific highlighter color and select text that you want to make a different color. Additionally, you can add notes by selecting the note button and clicking somewhere on the screen to add a note. There are other things you can add using the draw tool, like a rectangle or a text box, for example, or an oval to call attention to certain areas. This is useful for creating different styles of guides or instructional materials, as you can also change the different types of drawing mechanisms that exist. Additionally, you can add in a signature using the signature panel, or you can redact text in the file, removing important financial information or other data that should be removed. There are even more features, like adding additional pages to this file. We could select add pages, and we could either scan in multiple documents or add an entire other PDF to this file and then export it out as a singular PDF. Additionally, you can add in a header and footer by selecting the header and footer options. And then let's go ahead and add this header on the top of every single page. And I'm going to make it rather dramatic by saying I'm a header, and let's insert it onto all pages. We can also choose the location of where it's going to go and select save and add. And again, this is a 600 page document, so it's gonna take a moment to apply that header to every single page. So Abbyy Fine Reader PDF can be used as an alternative for editing your PDF files before sending them out to anybody. Additionally, you can actually create form features within Abbyy PDF. And the way that you would do that is by selecting the form editor from the top right menu. From here, you can add in text fields, checkboxes, radio buttons, OK buttons, and signature fields to your document by simply selecting the option you want to add and applying it to your page. Then this becomes a live field when you export it out to a PDF. Now, if you wanted to perform OCR on this file, the next step you could do is select the Recognize button and choose Recognize Document. And this will run OCR on the entire file. However, if your goal is to run OCR on a PDF, I highly recommend using the OCR editor within Abbyy Fine Reader PDF instead of the general PDF editor. Now that the OCR has been completed, a text layer has been added to the document so we can search and copy text. And just to follow up from earlier, my header was placed in the top right corner. So you can easily apply a header and footer to every single page in the document. Now that we've made all of the changes to our PDF that we want to make, let's go ahead and save out this file. I'm going to select the Save As button and then select Save. So this 600 page file took about 5 minutes to convert over to PDF, but let's go ahead and open up that new file. And I'm going to open this in Adobe Acrobat. Now, the first thing that I notice is that the comments I made are in the file and it allows me to jump directly to it. It adds the highlighted text, it adds the oval, things that can be done in Adobe Acrobat. However, Abbyy Fine Reader offers a different way to apply a lot of the same things that exist in Adobe Acrobat. Now, one more fun fact, let's take a look at the tags panel. So I'm going to open up the tags, and it does appear that there are some tags in the file, but we would certainly need to do quite a bit of work to make this file accessible. However, that's not the purpose of today's video. I hope you enjoyed watching this video on Abbyy Fine Reader 15 using the PDF editor to make changes to a PDF. This will probably be my last video I create on Abbyy Fine Reader PDF 15 because at the end of 2022, they actually released Abbyy Fine Reader 16. So be on the lookout for new videos covering Abbyy Fine Reader PDF version 16.